Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. Let's solve this geometry problem. The perimeter of a rectangle is 144 feet. The length is 3 times the width. Find the length and width of the triangle. I like to draw a picture. All right, so I'm going to draw a little picture of a rectangle. And so I'm going to think of the length as the long side and the width as the short side. So I read through this carefully. The perimeter is 144, so I know all the way around is 144. Okay. The length is 3 times the width. Now I don't know the width, but the length is 3 times that. So if I knew the width, I could multiply it by 3. So what I'm going to do is let the width be W. And I could just do that by putting the W on the width of this triangle I'm drawing. Some people like to write it out this way. The width is W. That's okay as well. Now the length is 3 times the width. So you can define your variables this way and say, well, if the width is 3, then the length is 3 times that. That'll be 3W, or you can just put it on your little diagram. You could do both, but you don't need to do both. All right, so what we've done here is define the width and we've defined the length using this variable W. And if you're more comfortable using an X, that's fine. I use W, so when I'm done, if I solve for W, I know that's what the width is going to be. Now, I know this perimeter is in feet, but I'm going to do the algebra without writing the feet. That's what's cool about algebra. It sort of helps you get the answer. And then our final answer, we have to remember to write the length and width using the correct units of feet. Okay, now, what else do we know? We need to get an equation here. The perimeter of a rectangle is 144 feet. Now, the perimeter means you just add all the sides. So one thing you can do is take and add the four sides of the rectangle. I'm going to show you the three ways people might set up an equation. Somebody might say, well, over here that's a W, and up here is a 3W. So if I add all four sides, that gives me W plus 3W plus another W plus 3W, and that equals 144. That's certainly true. Now, another formula for perimeter that you may have seen is that it's twice the width plus twice the length. All right, so we can also use this formula. What would that look like? Well, I would say twice the width. So what's the width in my diagram over here? It's W, so that's 2W plus twice the length. And the length is 3W, so it's 2 times 3W. Now, if you look at these two different equations, in the first equation, if you add the like terms, remember this is 1W and another 1W, you're going to get 8W equals 144. If you look at this second equation, you would first multiply the 2 times 3W, which is 6W, and when you add that to the 2W, you're also going to get 8W. So no matter which of these equations you happen to write down, you'll end up with 8W equals 144. So let me show you the steps had you written it this second way. 2W plus 6W equals 144, or 8W equals 144. And hopefully you'll notice that that's the same thing you would get if you added the like terms from this first equation I wrote. So there are a couple ways of doing it. Let's go ahead and finish this. How do you solve for W now? You need to divide both sides by 8. And so now we're going to just do our division. And that should give us, I think, 18. Now notice I put 18, not 18 feet. That's okay. We will take care of that eventually. So we have 18 for our width. So if I go back up to here, if you had written it this way, I could just write the 18 right now. And 3 times W would be 3 times 18, which is 54. And in fact, the shortcut for feet is just putting this little mark here. I'd have 18 feet and 54 feet. The other way of doing it is to look at the little picture. You said the width is 18, so you could put 18 feet here. And then I know the length is 3 times as long from my original picture I drew. So 3 times 18 is 54 feet. And of course that means this is 18 over here, right? And this is 54 here as well. So we can check that the perimeter really is 144. Let's just check it. If you add the sides of the rectangle, 18, 54, 18, 54, you do get 144, right? So you can check that the sides add up to the right amount here, right? So that seems to be our answer. Now here's a common mistake. Students will say that the width is 36 because they say, oh, it's 18 plus 18. No, 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 no. The width is just this length here on the side. So the width is 18 and the length is 54. And so that's how we want to write our answer. So we just write, the width is 18 feet and the length is 54 feet. Okay, I'm going to go back to my picture here in the beginning. All right, remember how we set it up? I sometimes think of it a little bit differently. If the perimeter is 144, then what would it be if I just went halfway around, right? So I just went along the length and around the width, okay? That's only halfway around. That would only be half the perimeter. I like to do my problems that way. I get easier numbers. So let me show you how that looks. So here's the picture again, and here's a little bit different reasoning. So let's just say we called the width, oh, let's see, sorry. We called that the width. Okay, so let's say we called this the width and that the length, and that's all I filled in. I note if I add those two numbers, I should get half the perimeter. If the whole perimeter is 144, what is half of that? 72. So another way of reasoning your answer here is to write the length plus the width is only halfway around. So that would be 72. I just get smaller numbers, a little bit easier equation to deal with, and I'll still get 18. 3W will still be 54, and my answer will be exactly the same. The width is still 18 feet, and the length is still 54 feet. It just gives you multiple ways to solve the same problem. So you have to, when you're working with word problems, you have a little bit of leeway, just like in most algebra problems, and you should do what makes this, you know, more sense to you. And this is an alternative way, not usually seen in algebra books, not usually explained this way by most teachers, but I like to give alternatives. So this works as well, as long as that makes sense to you. You're only going halfway around. But you could also go all the way around, right? Add all four sides to get 144, or use the formula for perimeter, twice the width plus twice the length, which was right here. And no matter how you do it, we all come up with the same answer, that the width is 18 feet and that the length is 54 feet. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.